What good is a crafting game if you can't even gather resources? Join me as I implement the first iteration of my game's inventory system. Welcome back to the Island54 Devlog. In today's episode, I'll be doing a bunch of the groundwork for the game's inventory system and getting it to the point where we can pick up and drop items. Before I get started on development, I wanted to talk a little bit about my game design philosophy in the hopes you'll understand why I'm trying what might be considered a slightly weird inventory system. I'll then go on to show how I implemented the first part of my inventory system. And lastly, I'll talk about what I'm planning in the next couple of episodes of the devlog. As always, I've included chapter marks and timestamps down in the description. I mentioned in the first episode that I would like to make a hyper-realistic crafting survival game. But what exactly do I mean by hyper-realistic? I want my game to be highly immersive. I want the player to be able to imagine that they themselves are trying to survive in the game world. So I started out by asking myself, if I inexplicably woke up one morning in the middle of a forest with no tools, what would I do? How would I survive? I want the player to start the game with only their two hands. It's enough to take their first sips of running water, to pick their first berries, and to nab some simple stone tools. Then they can bring some resources together from the area and start to build their first basic shelter. Later in the game, they will make bags and backpacks, barrels and chests, handcarts and caravans, better weapons and armor, and as they progress, they'll venture out of the protective embrace of the game's beginner area to start fighting for more valuable resources and slowly discover what makes a game world different to the real world. So where do we start? With just the character's two hands, of course. I started by mocking up a basic UI. It feels natural that what is in your hands should be visible on the screen. I place two squares on the bottom edge of the screen, with space between so I can place survival indicators later. We only have two item types at the moment, both stones, but we'll be adding more soon. I refactored the interaction system to make use of scriptable objects, similar to the approach used by Game Dev Guide in their video titled Creating an Inventory System in Unity. Don't worry though, I'll be covering the gist of it in here. I store all the attributes of an item in that scriptable object called item data, which allowed me to create template instances that can be referenced from other components. My item data class holds a prefab, an icon, and a list of actions that can be performed with the item. I'm sure I'll be adding more attributes soon though. I created an item data for each of my existing stones, and created icons using a free tool in the Unity Asset Store. I still needed to edit the icons to get rid of the background, but it was fine for only a couple of items. Maybe I'll need a better solution if I end up importing lots of objects from elsewhere at some point. I'll only be implementing pickup and put down for now, but I'll implement more actions in the next couple of episodes. I updated the terrain scatter code to use a reference to an item data instead of the prefab directly. As it places each item into the world, it adds an item component, which just holds a reference to the relevant item data for that item, so it can look it up again later. I tried to work out what information would be needed for pickup and put down. Players need to be able to pick up an item by hitting the use key while targeting an item in the world. They might be able to put one down though by hitting the use key while not targeting an item, or maybe directly from their inventory. The pop-up menu code can ask the action if it can be performed within a given context, then ask that action to be performed. Each of the calls takes who is doing the action, which hand or inventory slot they're doing it with, and optionally, the targeted item or location within the world. This interface feels a bit fragile to me. I don't like the fact that I've coupled the inventory system and the action system so tightly, but I don't want to spend too long on this, and this seems to do the job for now. The inventory system is made up of two slots for now. Each slot stores its location, either primary hand or secondary hand, and if there's an item in that slot, the item data being stored there. Next, I needed to actually implement the actions. The pickup code is pretty straightforward. It copies the reference to the relevant item data in the appropriate inventory slot, then removes its game object from the world. The put-down code is only marginally trickier, since we need to know where to put the item down. It moves the item data out of the relevant inventory slot, then instantiates and configures a new game object in the world. Notice how the item data follows the objects around, whether they're instantiated in the world or being stored in our inventory. This allows us to easily move them back and forth between the world and our inventory. I then updated the pop-up menu code to dynamically query which actions are available within the current context, so I don't show both pickup and put-down at the same time. It felt a bit weird seeing the pop-up menu when pickup is the only option, so I changed the code to skip the menu when there's only one option, but still show it if the option is sort of destructive, like a drop action. I added a secondary use control and bound it to the Q key. Since everything already referenced the relevant inventory slot, I wired up the new action and gave it a try. I found it pretty intuitive to use this new inventory system, which is a really good sign. In the next episode, I'll be adding our first crafting recipe, allowing the player to craft a hand axe from these stones, and adding trees and sticks to the game. After that, I'll be expanding out the inventory system a bit, so I can play around with some ideas around how the player might be able to store resources in preparation for building their first structure. Now, before we finish up, it's now time for Comment of the Week. This week's Comment of the Week comes from Kibby, who mentions they've always wanted to try Linux, but never gotten around to it. Sounds kind of familiar. Of course, if you want a low-risk way of trying it out, you can always install it on a virtual machine and see what you think of it. So that pretty much wraps it up for this episode of the Island54 Devlog. If you enjoyed this episode, be sure to leave a thumbs up. If you didn't enjoy it but watched to the end anyway, be sure to leave a mean comment down below. And until next time, happy game developing.